الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنام سيدنا ونبينا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الكرام بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده فجزاه الله عنا وعن الأمة كل خير. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Lord, the Lord of the worlds, our Creator, our Sustainer, our Master, and peace and blessings upon His prophets and messengers, all the prophets and messengers of Allah, from Adam alayhi salam to Nuh alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, and the last and the final Prophet Muhammad salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi wa alayhi wa ajma'in. May the peace and blessing of Allah be upon him, upon all the prophets, and upon their families, upon their followers. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us among them. I will witness that there is no God except Allah. And I will witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final prophet and messenger. You just heard the adhan. And we hear it 5 times a day. We hear the adhan and we hear the iqamah, and there are certain words that are repeated in our adhan. And I would like to mention one statement that is mentioned, and that is Hayya ala al-Falah. So you are Hayya ala al-Salah and you are Hayya ala al-Falah. And these two are called Al-Hayya ala al-Tain. Hayya ala, Hayya ala. Come to Salah, come to Falah. So the Muazzin is inviting people to come to Falah. Falah is, of course, Falah means success. And that means come to Salah. Salah is the way of success. Some people might think it's a waste of time. Coming 5 times a day, I'm leaving my business, I'm doing this, I'm like that. No, this is the way of success. Your business is the way of success, yes, but this is also the way of success. So come to Salah and come to Falah. Now Falah is not only in Salah. Actually Falah is the whole way of Islam. When Rasulullah started preaching the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Makkah, he used to tell the people going in the streets of Makkah, Ya ayyuhannas, qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu. Oh people, say la ilaha illallah, you will become successful. And you know, Arabs were not successful at that time. They were divided. They were backward. They were not like Egyptians, they were not like Syrians, they were not like Romans, they were not like Greeks, they were not like Chinese or Indians. They were behind all the people. But Rasulullah told them, قُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ تُفْلِحُوا. Say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ and you will become successful. So Falah is the mission of Islam. Falah is the message of Islam. Islam wants you to come success, to become successful people. And Falah, literally the word Falah, in Arabic you call it Falah. Falah is the performer. The one who cultivates the land, put the seed, waters, take care of it, and then you expect good crop. So Falah is the farmer. Falah, yaflah means to cultivate. Falah is the cultivation. Falah means that you work And through your work, you will become successful. That's why if Allah is important, He does a lot of good work. And in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned the word falah many times. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, qada falah al-mu'minun, believers are successful. And then there is another word that is mentioned in the Quran called al-fawz. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ. Great fawz. Fawz is also success. And there is another word in the Arabic language that we use for success. It's called najah. But najah is not mentioned in the Quran. In the Quran, Allah SWT has mentioned falah and fawz. Because falah and fawz, falah especially, falah means success here in this world and success in the hereafter. And salah, falah is a positive word. It's falah of the individual, falah of the community, falah here in this world, falah in the hereafter. So falah in this world means you have good job, you have good health, you have good family, you have good reputation, and you are worried, you don't have worries, alhamdulillah, that's falah. Everybody wants that. There is no person who will say, I don't want good health. Everybody wants good health. And they will say, I don't want good business. No, want good business. You want to be successful in your business. You want to be successful in your family. Your children are nice, obedient. Your wife, your spouse, caring, loving. Your neighbors are good, you have a good neighborhood. All of these things are considered as success in this world. But we want also success in the hereafter. Allah be pleased with us. We live in Jannah. Receive the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where there is life, no death. Where there are riches, no poverty. Where there is health, no sickness. Where there is goodness, nothing evil. So that is the success of the akhirah. Najah, as I mentioned, najah, the word najah also means success, but it is not mentioned in the Quran. Because najah, success, could be good, could be bad. Somebody will be very successful in business, but he's cheating, lying, making fraud. So najah is najah, but he is not a good person. Somebody will be successful in the battle, but he is doing war crimes, killing innocent people. So yeah, they are successful in their battles, but this is not a success, this is not a real success. So real success, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not used this word, najah, in the Quran. Because najah could be positive, najah could be negative. But fawz and falah are always good. Fawz is used for Quran, in the Quran for Jannah. Dhalika al-fawz al-mubin, that is the great success. So going to Jannah is called al-fawz al-mubin. Islam emphasizes that you struggle to have this success of falah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, believers are successful. Qad aflaha al-mu'minun, qad aflaha al-mu'minun. You know the previous surah, in the Surah Al-Mu'minun, and then the Surah Al-Hajj before that, Surah number 22, and Surah Al-Mu'minun, Surah number 23, Surah Al-Hajj ends in the Huda Yuflahul Kafirun. So Surah ends, Surah Al-Hajj ends with that, Kafirs will not succeed. And Surah Al-Mu'minun begins, Qad aflaha al-mu'minun. Because there is always connection in one surah to another surah. Sometimes connection with words, sometimes connection with meanings, sometimes connection with something. That's why in order to understand a surah, you have to read the previous surah. And you have to read that surah. So beginning of the surah, end of the surah, and you can connect everything. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Believers are successful. Islam is the way of success. If Muslims are failures, is Muslims are not doing anything. There's something wrong in their practice of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not wrong. You know, somebody said, recited the ayah, he said that لَنْ يَجْعَلَ اللَّهُ لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ سَبِيلًا. Allah will not give upper hand to kafirs over the believers. So the person asked the Shaykh, Shaykh, Allah said that, but we see all around the kafirs have upper hand and Muslims don't. What is the answer for that? And Allah says that Allah will never give upper hand to kafirs over the believers. But this man said, over Muslims. He said, Allah did not say Muslims, Allah said believers. Are we really believers? If you are real believers, then it will happen. That means we have to ask ourselves. We have to ask, the Ummah has to ask. Everybody has to ask themselves, where is my iman? How am I my commitment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised success for believers. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Did not say قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ. And I'm not saying there's a problem between Muslims and iman. But yes, Muslims are supposed to be the mu'min, and mu'min are supposed to be Muslims. But there are some people that are just Muslims in the name. I'm Muslim. So they are 2 billion Muslims in the world. And you have, our ulama said that the Rasulullah was sent to all the world. So all the world, everybody that lives in this world, 5 billion, 6 billion people in the world, they are all Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everybody is Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everybody that you go out and see on the street, they are all Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But they mention that Ummah is in 3 levels. There is Ummah to da'wah. Rasulullah was sent everybody to receive the message of Allah. So they are all Ummah to da'wah. And then he said, among the Ummah to da'wah, there are some who listen to him. رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيَا يُنَادِي بِالْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا. Lord, we have heard somebody calling us to Iman and we accepted it. This is call. So that's they call it Ummah to Ijabah. So Ummah to da'wah, the Prophet was sent to them, that is all the humanity. And among the humanity, there are 2 billion people who are Ummah to Ijabah. They said, yes, we recognize Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Allah's messenger. We recognize that there is no God except Allah. So this is Ummah to Ijabah. But then they say there is another group among this, Ummah to Ijabah, and that's called Ummah to Ittiba'. The people who follow him, the people who take his call seriously, they don't simply say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, but they live by it. So this is the real thing. The real thing is to live by that, Ummah to Ittiba'. So those who follow him, as Rasulullah said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my example and the example of the people is, somebody made a nice banquet and sent invitation to the people, come. Those who come, they will enjoy the banquet. And those who do not come, they will not enjoy the banquet. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the beautiful message, that is ma'lubatullah. And what is the ma'lubatullah? What is the banquet of Allah? It's the Quran. Ma'lubatullah bi'abdullah. Quran is Allah's banquet. And those who come and take the Quran seriously, they enjoy the banquet. And they will go to Jannah and have the bigger banquet. Yes, inshallah. So the point is to accept the message. And the point is to live by the message and follow that in every way. The whole life. Not just prayers. Not just fasting. Not only ibadat. But ibadat and the mu'amalat. That is, worship Allah and you deal with the people in an honest way. In a nice way. In a good way. It is mentioned that one day Rasulullah made wudu in front of the Sahaba. Sahaba watched him making wudu, and after he finished his wudu, they came to shake hands with the Prophet. His hands were wet, so their hands became wet with the wudu of the Prophet. Wudu means the water of the of wudu of the Prophet. So they put it over their faces. The wet hands touched the hand of Rasulullah and they put it on their faces. On their, they rubbed their faces, they rubbed their hands. And Rasulullah asked them, مَا حَمَلَكُمْ عَلَى هَذَا? Why did you do that? He didn't say don't do that, because of course Rasulullah is a blessing in Rasulullah in everything. So he didn't say, but he simply asked them, so what did, why did you do that? مَا حَمَلَكُمْ عَلَى هَذَا? And of course, the Sahaba answered, well, حُبُّ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. The love of Allah and the Messenger of Allah. Out of love, you did that, Ya Rasulullah. Of course, any one of us would have been there, we would have done the same thing. I'll touch my hand a million times, I'll kiss my hand a million times, my hand will touch the hands of Rasulullah. What an honor! Sahaba had this honor. But Rasulullah did not just tell them that, okay, just do that. No, he pointed something else. And Rasulullah wanted to take them a step further. He said, مَنْ سَرَّهُ أَنْ يُحِبَّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. And then he said further, وَمَنْ سَرَّهُ أَنْ يُحِبَّهُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. Anyone who likes to love Allah and His Messenger, and anyone who likes that Allah and His Messenger love him, and you love Allah, but also Allah and His Messenger love you. This is the real thing. That is, Allah and His Messenger love you. Anyone who likes to love Allah and His Messenger, and anyone likes to see that Allah and His Messenger love him, فَلْيَسْتُقْ حَدِيثَهُ إِذَا حَدَّثَ. Let him speak the truth whenever he speaks. Always speak the truth. وَلْيُؤَدِّ أَمَانَتَهُ إِذَا تُمِنْ. And when somebody gives him the amana, fulfill the amana. Be a trustworthy person. Be a truthful person and be a trustworthy person. As-Sadiq al-Amin. That's what Rasulullah he was known as As-Sadiq al-Amin. So that's why he said that. And it's not enough just to touch my hands. It is the character, akhlaq, manners. فَلْيَسْتُقْ حَدِيثَهُ إِذَا حَدَّثَ وَلْيُؤَدِّ أَمَانَتَهُ إِذَا تُمِنْ. And then the third thing he said, وَلْيُحْسِنْ جِوَارَ مَنْ جَوَّرَ. And be good to your neighbors. Be nice to your neighbor. These are the three very, very essential things. That if you follow truth, if you are Amin, and you are good in your relations with everybody, that is the way of success. These are the... If people want to be successful, even the worldly thing, become successful in this way. We have a brother here, I don't want to mention the name. He is, mashallah, a very successful businessman. He said when he came from India, he had only a few dollars in his pocket. He arrived at LAX, and somebody told him, go and first thing is to learn driving. Because in America, you can't do anything without driving. So you go and drive, learn driving, and then he learned the driving, and then after that, he saw somewhere. Apply for employment, looking for somebody to work. So he worked in that restaurant. And then soon he became promoted and promoted. And then the opportunity came to buy the restaurant. And he went to take the loan. And he got good recommendation from the manager, from the owner. And he bought the restaurant. And then he bought one restaurant, and he bought another one, another one. Now he has, mashallah, more than 100. And he mentioned, said that there are two things that helped me in my success. One of them, I worked very hard. And the second thing, I was nice to the people. I was courteous to the people. And that is, he said, Allah, of course, Allah is the one who gives the success. But these are the two things that I did. I didn't do anything more than that. And I worked very hard I was punctual and so unreliable and also very good in my relation to the people. Customers, everybody I tried to do. See that? These are the akhlaq of Islam. These are the way of success. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that many times in the Quran, there are many ayat in the Quran that talk about success. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ruk'u wasjudu wa'budu rabbakum waf'alu al-khayr la'allakum tuflihun. When you believe, make ruku, make sajda, make ibadah, worship Allah, serve Allah, and do good so that you become successful. Now somebody might say, but is it all the same thing? Ruku, sujood, ibadah. But no, ruku and sujood are ibadat. U'budu rabbakum, live your life in service of Allah. So ibadah is not just salat, ibadah is your whole life. And then he says, do good things. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ And khayr is a very broad word. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ So this is the way of success. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in another place, that you have to be together, united with each other. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Or you believe, be mindful of Allah, as you ought to be mindful of Him and live your whole life until the end of Muslims. And then says, وَأَقْتَسِمُوا بِحَبِّ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا And then furthermore Allah says, وَلَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ So you hold all of you together, the rope of Allah, that means be united, don't be divided, and hold the rope of Allah that means the Quran, and at the same time I say, and be invite other people to it, that is good. وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ There be among you a group of people who invite to all that is good, command what is right, forbid what is wrong, and they are the ones who will be successful. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ In at the end of Surah Al-Imran, the Surah Al-Imran talks about the social responsibilities of Muslims. And so in this surah, the last ayah of the surah is, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sabiru wa sabiru wa rabitu wa taqullaha la'allakum tuflihun. That is the end of the Surah Al-Imran. For you believe, be patient. Patient means be steadfast. Wa sabiru, and remind each other to be patient. Be steadfast. You know, sabr means patient in a situation of difficulty. And sabr means also patient on ta'at, on the obedience to Allah. That means firm on the obedience of Allah. And sabr anil ma'asi, sabr means control yourself from committing sin. Isbiru wa sabiru wa rabitu. And rabitu is watch, guard yourself from those who will attack you and those who will try to defame you and do all those kinds of things, be together. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ And be mindful of Allah so that you become successful. So these are the things that are needed for success here in this life and success in the life to come. And furthermore, you will find in the Quran many places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, who are the people who will not be successful? May be successful here for a short time in this world, but certainly not in the hereafter. Allah said, إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ Zalims will not be successful. Zalim is somebody who does wrong thing, and somebody who does injustice, and somebody who is oppressor, and somebody who is hard towards other people. إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ Zulm has zulm duna zulm, different levels of zulm. الظُلْم هو بَوْعُ الشَّيْءِ فِي غَيْرِ مَحَلِّهِ Zulm is that you don't do the right thing. So إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ The criminals, they will not be successful on the day of judgment. لَا يُفْلِحُ الصَّاحِرُونَ Magicians will not be successful. That means those who came to Musa alayhi salam and they wanted to trick him, they are not successful. And anybody, there are a lot of magicians today who are trying to mislead people by their propaganda. They may think that they are successful with that, but they will not succeed. And Allah says, إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. The disbelievers will not be successful. So Islam is the way of success. But Muslims have to follow that. Muslims have to live by that. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us success in this life and in the life to come. And not only we, but lead the world to success, inshallah. Lead the world, everybody, to the right path. Inshallah. Allahu ta'ala, alhamdulillah, rabbil alamin. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. Should keep in our mind Muslims in the world who are suffering and they are suffering because the Ummah is not together because of the difficulties that their people are facing. So we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring the Ummah together, yeah. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that those especially who are suffering, such as the people of Rohingya in the area that was known before as Burma, Myanmar now is called, and the people especially now, we are hearing the news, horrible news of the suffering of the people of Yoga. That is Kashala, that is the northwest part of China, and this whole area is millions of Muslims there, and they are going through a lot of difficulty. Some of them are put in concentration camps and asked to renounce their religion. If they say the name Islamic name, then they are punished for that. They cannot have copies of the Quran, they cannot grow beard, they cannot wear caps, Islamic caps. So there are a lot of difficulties for them. And they are asked to renounce their faith. It is a horrible condition that they are going on. And it's recognized, not only as somebody saying this, the United Nations is spoken about that. So, but a lot of people don't know about this. So we pray to Allah, include them in our prayer. We include in our prayer all the people of Palestine, people of Kashmir. Include in our prayer people suffering in Syria, people suffering in Yemen. And some of all these are problems that are man-made problems. And then also there are some natural disasters. We pray for the people who are suffering because of tsunami in Indonesia and other places. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this Ummah. And help the people to understand their responsibility and come together. And also remember our sister Sharifa, she passed away 2 days ago, and her janazah will be at the Islamic Society immediately after the Salat. But burial is also in the, at 3 o'clock at the Westminster Lawn. So those of you can go, please attend that. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless her. And give patience to her family. اللهم اغفر لها وارحمها. اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا ورجلنا وانثى. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. خصوصا على الخلفاء الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعلى سائر الصحابة والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بفضلك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اجمع كلمة المسلمين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبهم. اللهم أصلح ذات بينهم. اللهم أعطنا النصر والفوز والنجاح في الدنيا والآخرة. رب اغفر وارحم وانت خير الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. إن الصلاة وتنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر.